Good morning, guys, and welcome back. I hope everybody had a fantastic break. I'm wishing you a happy new year and many, many awesome travels in 2024. And as you can see, I'm in our beautiful old town of Tallinn. It is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. It is probably the best preserved medieval town in Europe. And majority of the buildings here are actually dating back from about the same time, which is around 14th, 16th century. And majority of the buildings here do take the inspirations in architecture and design from the German culture around that time. And all of this actually got me thinking about the Estonian design and how does it look, where you can actually see it, is it tightly connected to our northern neighboring countries such as Finland and Sweden? I'll try to answer all these questions in this video. And since Estonians are known for its craftsmanship, I'll try to do something with my own hands and hopefully I don't disappoint. Guys, welcome to the Estonian Design Uncovered. Our first spot today is Estonian Museum of Applied Art and Design, which I personally think is a great place to start from if you want to learn more about the Estonian design and its history. It is conveniently located in the old town, so it's easily accessible, and it also has this gorgeous medieval courtyard. Look at this. And this is my invitation to you guys to turn to as many corners as possible whilst you're exploring the old town of Tallinn, because it's just really beautiful. And didn't mention it's really, really cold today. It's currently minus 20 degrees. Yes, winter is in Tallinn in January. Oh, my mouth is frozen. Are particularly cold. So I'm very happy to get in and warm myself inside.
The Estonian Museum of Applied Art and Design displays over 18,000 design prototypes, making it the largest and the most comprehensive collection of the Estonian design, which is really good when you're trying to learn about the design history of an entire country.
What I love is that the museums in the old town of Tallinn are like these historic artifacts themselves. In our case, the Museum of Estonian Applied Art and Design is located in the 17th century Baroque house that was actually used to store grain, and now it has been reshaped and redesigned into this beautiful design museum.
The museum is spread across three floors with two permanent exhibitions. Level 2 is fully dedicated to the Estonian Applied Art, and level 3 is focused on the history of the Estonian design, which I'm all about today. And to help me navigate over 100 years of Estonian design history, I'm meeting Kai Lobjakas, who has devoted over 20 years to archiving and documenting Estonian design.
I'm Kai Lobjakas from the Museum of Applied Art and Design. I'm the curator of the exhibition. A big part of my task has actually been building the design collection at the museum, so I've been really privileged to do that over the course of years. I like the theory or idea of design growing layers on it. So it's changing, but it doesn't really lose what it has had before. This also applies to the Estonian design. So actually, this is the plywood part, and it was very, very traditional what they were actually doing there. They were just taking very typical things and producing them in Estonia. Especially these pieces, they're super, super light, like three-layered plywood makes them very light. There's this butterfly screw which you can tighten up, and then it becomes a very ergonomic seat. So this is a lovely, lovely piece.
What's the rarest piece that you have here?
So we were very, very lucky to actually get perhaps these two pieces that were staying with the designers of the time. Two experimental pieces for the exhibition, the seat and the lighting, and the experimental part in it being that you can see the shower tube and the wash basin, and they were never multiplied, and they are just, you know, one of. During the 60s, modernist kind of take on design was basically the same everywhere. And being in the vicinity of Scandinavia, of course it influenced the local scene. There was an Estonian design exhibition in Helsinki at the Art Hall at Taidehalli in 59. And in 61, there was the Finnish design exhibition in Tallinn in the Art Hall.
Seriously, I think 70s and 80s period is my favorite one so far. It's very bold, it's very vibrant, and it's still pretty functional though.
So we have, yeah, the experimental part here, which gives the idea of how the interior designers were really trying to rethink the idea of furniture, of a chair mostly. So it was very much based on the idea of chair and lighting.
I need this chair in my office so I can make very important decisions on this chair. I was actually really happy to learn that Estonian design is pretty cold. Practical, which actually I feel like fits our Estonian spirit really, really well. And since design is tightly governed by craftsmen and craftswomen, our next spot is Telliskivi. It literally has the highest amount of independent craft stores here in Tallinn, and it also happens to be my favorite neighborhood, so let's go. Can you say the sun makes all the difference? Ah, love it. And as you can see, behind me is the old town, and I can already see the graffiti of Telliskivi in front of me. So this neighborhood is so close to the old town that you don't have any excuses not to check it out. Honestly, no matter how often I come here, I always feel cool. Looking at all this amazing, colorful graffiti, it's just the creative energy here is absolutely palpable. And I'm here to meet the coolest fashion designer, Reet Aus. Her biggest focus is on how to make fashion industry absolutely sustainable at the factory level. She's a legit leading expert here in Estonia, plus I get to see all her cool designer clothes. Let's get in.
My name is Reet Aus. I'm a senior researcher at the Estonian Academy of Arts. I'm the creative designer in South Design, and our collection is Reet Aus.
I can see that you have a lovely arrow here, and I can see a lot of items here that do have arrows as well. What does it mean?
Arrow is actually a symbol of upcycling. Upcycling is you take, I don't know, old jeans, or you take industrial leftovers and just make clothes out of it. It's the most efficient way to use already existing materials. And this is our most complicated product. This is made from the 50 different small pieces, so you can see from inside. This is the three lions. We have a big factory in Bangladesh we're working with. We have our own line inside the factory. Once a month they send us swatches, what kind of leftovers materials they have easily available for us. We usually just use plain colors because then it's easier to mix and match. Because all our clothes are like cut and sew methods, put together from many pieces.
I'm quite a visual person and I really love this representation, the small little stand here in Reet Aus concept store shop, where she showcases how your old denim jeans can become this awesome t-shirt here.
Right now we are using recycled yarn from Italy, which is very good quality.
Levi's jeans here that you're no longer using, no longer wearing, instead of just throwing them away, they break them down into the small denim pieces here. Then we get these little yarn bits here that then are literally made into this beautiful yarn.
And the method how we are producing them is like 3D knitted, so it's seamless. It's really cool. They start from there and it ends like here. So basically it's completely waste-free production.
Honestly, when I hear fancy, new age technologies and designer clothing, I rarely think affordable. So I'm happy to say that the prices here have really surprised me in a good way, and I'm definitely coming back for some personal shopping. Plus, you can't deny this stuff looks really cool. I think a lot of people who come here to Estonia usually do have questions like, what is Estonian design? How would you describe Estonian design?
I would say Estonian design is very practical, minimalistic, very good quality because we are very strong in the craft side. And I think the craft and technology are the two like keywords and how they are combined.
What's really cool about craft people in Telliskivi is that they all are real close to each other, which I particularly appreciate in this weather. I'm not gonna lie, I'm really loving the fact that the philosophy of the current Estonian design is built around sustainability, circularity, and making as little waste as humanly possible. And now it's finally time for me to make something pretty at Stella Soomlais' leather workshop. I'm actually going to be accompanied by Stella herself. She is a sustainability teacher at the Estonian Academy of Arts, and she is responsible for probably one of the coolest leather backpacks that I have ever seen.
Today we're going to do a little workshop. We're going to use our scraps and craft a little armlet. I'm Stella Soomlais. I work mostly with leather. I'm also a tutor in Estonian Academy of Arts, doing the same thing, accessory design and also sustainability. We have this open kitchen format that we are doing mostly the production here. We also have a shop.
All right, so what's the first step? What are we going to do now?
It's the hardest. You have to choose the color. as leather is with its unique shape, then always we're going to have like leftovers. And the average is otherwise in the industry is like 20-25%. As we are so small, our average leftover is like 2-4%. But it still means that we're going to have some bits and pieces. And workshops are definitely one of the like ways how to use them.
I'm going
to
be a boring one. I think I'm going to go for a black one, yeah.
I think working with leather, the best thing is that when you know how to do that, then you can manipulate a lot. Leather enables molding, leather enables some embossing, so it's just like a lot of things you can do as a crafter.
Yeah, it went through. Oh, yay! I made a hole, Mom!
In the middle.
Almost in the middle.
Yeah.
Our designs are modular, so that if something happens, then we can just like, for example, change the strap or the zipper or the pocket. And now you have to choose silver look or brass look.
Definitely silver. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you need two of those, like one of that, one of that. And then here, I'm gonna put a bit of glue so that it would not unscrew itself.
Oh, I see. Yeah, it's going in.
We have also the possibility that you buy a bag, you wear it for 2 years, and then you don't need to carry, like, for example, a computer with you. Then you can bring the bag back. We give you the credit for the new bag, and then you can choose, like, a smaller handbag, for example. So the bags keep coming back to us. Then it's also possible to detach everything and then make new items out of the used leather already. But as we use vegetable tan leather, then it ages beautifully. It has a patina, which means that if we make new items out of it, then it's even more worth because it has time like written all over it and it's unique.
So we have our ready-made bracelet here. I'm not gonna lie, I literally copy-pasted Stella's design that she has here on her hand. I really like the black leather, it really looks awesome, and the small touch of the plane, just a small reminder to myself to, you know, buy that ticket spontaneously and go and see the world every now and again.
Good job.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much, Stella, for bearing with me during this workshop. If you can't see it from my face, I absolutely enjoyed it. And who knew that making something with your own hands can be so satisfying? Also, I'm here, I really want to share with you two more shops that I think you should definitely check out. One is located literally behind me. It's called Tallinn Concept Store. And another one is called Tallinn Design House that is located in Rotterdam Quarter, very close to the Vero Center and city center in general. And both of the shops sell exclusively Estonian designer items. They're of high quality and they will definitely make for a great souvenir, and I think it's a really good way to support local Estonian design scene. And I want to finish this video on a super high note because we have finally launched the Tallinn Card app. It's absolutely free to download. It has tons of useful information and useful, super informative tips that even I'm mining from. So yeah, get it on your phone, use it, and let us know how you like it. My name is Polly. Thanks so much for watching this video, and I will see you in the next episode. Whew. Somebody get me a hot cocoa.